First of all, I would like to congratulate the organizers because we are in a moment in which we cannot postpone anymore the role that the academic, scientific and artistic community must have, because for the first time in history we are facing irreversible processes, and therefore we can reach points of no return, and this is an immense responsibility that we have. And I like very much what it is said indeed when he said the World Academy of Art and Science, leadership in thought that leads action. Action. Now it has been also in the speech of David, it has been very clear that what we need is action, and to be able to transform in reality many impossibles today of things that we have been until now only as spectators. The academic community, the universities, we have been only as other persons that are spectators instead of being actors of their problem. It is true that when we talk about education, future education, the first thing is that we must realize that we are talking for education for all, because until very recently, only 25, 30 years ago, was not for all, and was always thinking that education was for the children. And education, I remember, it was the first conclusion of the first Congress, World Congress on Education, that took place in 1990 in Jomtien in Thailand, was precisely education for all throughout life. Throughout life. Nobody can say, no, I have lost already the train of education. No, we must be aware that education is for life, and that we are always, during some years we are only receiving, but afterwards we'll become also persons that can have their experience, that is a wonderful treasure that must be shared with others. And then another thing that I would like to say is that until 25 years or something like this, and this has been also emphasized before, David has emphasized this, most of the human beings were isolated. The human beings, 95-96%, were being born, living and dying in some 50 kilometers, square kilometers. And this was the life of 95% of the people until very recently. And then suddenly it appears that we are able to know what happens in the world as a whole. We are able to express ourselves. This is fantastic. This is the new era. The new era is that until this moment we were silent, we were obedient, because we were isolated and we were living in different parts. Normally was related with agriculture in our places. And then suddenly we were able to express ourselves progressively. We were able to know what was happening in all the world. Until this moment was also in our very close environment. And what is more important, and I would like to emphasize this because it's crucial for the future of education, is the role of women. Until this moment, I must tell you, I remember when I was a professor and I started the diagnosis of irreversible damage precisely in the neuron of the children in the Granada University, was the year 67 when I started making this diagnosis that now are compulsory in all the world for the children after 48 hours of being born. And I remember that I decided to give the responsibility of this very big project, biomedicine project, in all Spain, to one woman. And there were many people that came and said, Professor Mayor, you know that you are giving all the responsibility to a woman? Yes, because it was very, very, very seldom that this possibility was done. And I must also tell you another thing related with this, even if it is not very much on future education, but as I said, that in the year 1996 they had the opportunity to visit again one of the persons that has had more influence in me was President Nelson Mandela. I was already knowing him from when he was in the Robben Island prison, but at this moment he was already 3 years president of South Africa, and I went to see him and they said, you know, I am very disappointed because all this thing that I am promoting is the culture of peace instead of culture of war, culture of peace, instead of saying always, si vis pacem para verum, si vis peace prepare war, we were going now to do the opposite, si vis pacem para verbum, we will make the transition from force to word. And I said, I am very disappointed because I realized that this is not appreciated, this is not taken, and he told me, this is because until now, all the power, now if you close the eyes and you see the history, always has been absolute male power in the history. Only sometimes with dynastic questions there was a woman that was in the power, but normally were always absolute male power. And when the women arrived to the power, sometimes, well, it's logic, she was having a mimetic role because she was only, as reference, always male power. And he told me, but now, from now on, we will see that in 20, 30 years, we will have, and he told me, the cornerstone of the new era. The cornerstone of the new era will be women. And I look at him saying, why? And he told me, because women only exceptionally utilizes force. Men only exceptionally do not. And therefore, now we must realize that yes, we are, when we talk about future education, we are for the first time in history talking about all, and all means all human beings, not only the men, that was what happened before the IDP. Before 30 years ago, we were giving our own life, because was, the main power said, now you must go to war, we were going to eat, you know, and the floods and all these things, and this has been a terrible history. But now for the first time, now we can express ourselves, we are not more fearful, because we were fearful, and was logical. And precisely, if you read the Declaration of Human Rights, you will see that in the preamble, the first paragraph of the preamble says, these rights are to save humanity from fear. And this is what I think that is very important to know, that when you say you are free and you have the capacity of living all together, a very important part of this first article of the human rights says, and you will live in brotherhood with the others. This is fantastic, because this is exactly when I asked Jacques Delors to chair the commission that gave this education for the 21st century, they said that the first thing is learn to be, not learn one thing or another, no, learn to be a human being. And what is to be a human being? And this is the article number one of the UNESCO's constitution, is to be free and responsible. This is to be educated, because sometimes now, when we have these reports coming on education from institutions that are economic institutions, etc., they do not refer to learn to be. They say learn to be a good consumer, for example, or learn mathematics, or learn English. You must know a lot of languages. Yes, very good, but this is not education. This is professional learning. This is having some capacities, some training that is very important. But you can know a lot of biochemistry, and you can be a profound maleducated person. Therefore, we must realize that education, article number one of UNESCO, is to be free and responsible. And Jacques Delors said, first, learn to be. Second, learn to know. No, knowledge is not information. This is another thing that we must know very well when we talk about the future of education. One thing is knowledge, that is this information that you have been having thinking on this, you have incorporated, you have put in the different ways. That is knowledge, is your knowledge that comes from information. And also another thing that we must distinguish very well is information from news, because news are the informations that are very extraordinary information, because it's for this that they are a news, because otherwise will be not. But we must take this into account, because today we have a very rapid information through news, and we must realize that these news do not reflect what happens as a whole in the community. For example, when it is said that one teacher has had some wrong treatment with one of the pupils, we must close the eyes and say, how many teachers are in this country or in this place, and how many pupils? Because otherwise we immediately exaggerate, and we have not a good knowledge of what has happened, because we have had not the right information concerning this. Well, what I wanted to tell you is that for me, future education is to learn to be a human being. And to be a human being is a wonder. It's a wonder. Every human being is unique. This is the immense diversity. The limit of diversity is unicity. Every human being is unique and distinct at every moment of his or her life. Biologically, we have about 1 million mutations per day, biologically, but also from the intellectual point of view. We are changing continually. We are looking, we are remembering, we are forgiving. Therefore, we must realize that every human being is able to, is the faculties that are distinctive of the human being. We are able to think, we are able to imagine, we are able to anticipate. This morning it has also been underscored this. We are able to anticipate what could happen. We can know the different possible scenarios, and therefore to promote those that are better for our aims. Therefore, we are able to think, we are able to imagine, we are able to anticipate, we are able to innovate, we are able to create. Every human being is able to create, and we must give the possibility for every human being to have the design of his own or her own destiny. I think that this is fantastic, and this is our hope. I remember when President Kennedy, in a moment in which he said, no, all these things have no solution, all these things have no solution. Peace is a utopia. Disarmament is impossible. And he said, and perhaps he was killed quite afterwards, perhaps it was because of this, because he said, we cannot say never that is impossible. He said, I will demonstrate that peace is feasible, that disarmament is feasible. And he added something that we must have in our minds. He said, because there is no any challenge beyond the distinctive capacity of every human being to create. We can create, we can design our own future. The education that gives this capacity to every human being, not to be a spectator, to be an actor of his or her own life, the capacity of creating all together, living all together, to live all together, was the fourth via that Jacques Delors gave for education. To be, to know, to do, and to live together. Thank you very much.